A very warm good morning to one and all present over here class. Welcome to the digital platform of APS. Now this is Pavan Kumar. Today I will start 5th lecture of chapter 2 relation and function. So class, in previous lecture I have discussed about the function. Now in today lecture I will start with the graph of function. So let us start with this topic, graph of functions. Heading is graph of functions. Now first of all I will discuss with the identity function. This is the type of function. First part, identity function. So identity function, what is identity function? Let y is equal to fx, let y is equal to fx be a function such that fx is equal to fx is equal to x, fx is equal to x, and for all x, for all is small x belongs to real number, for all small x belongs to real number, then the function we can write here if let y is equal to fx be a function, if fx is equal to x for all small x belongs to R, then the function is said to be identity function. Then the function is said to be identity function or known as identity function. So see its graph. Suppose this is x-axis and y-axis. You have given x-axis and y-axis. This is origin, coordinate 0, 0. Now you have to draw, or what is function? This is function. Y is equal to fx. And fx is equal to x. This is the function. Now when you will put x is equal to 1, you will get y is equal to 1. X is equal to 2, you will get y is equal to 2. X is equal to 3, you will get y is equal to 3. So this type of function you will obtain. This is the function. Y is equal to fx and fx is equal to x. This is also known as, this is known as identity function. And it's a terminology. This is the equation of line passes through origin and making an angle of 45 degree with the positive direction of x-axis for the line y is equal to x. Suppose you have to find out domain. It's a domain. What will be its domain? See, from figure. Domain is the values of x at which the function is defined. So, domain is real number. So, you can take R. And what is range? Range is also real number. That is also R. So you have to remember these points. Now I will come to the next type. The next type is constant function. See, second type is constant function. What is constant function? Let y is equal to fx be a function. Let y is equal to fx be a function we have taken. Now if the function, if fx is equal to k, suppose k is the constant, fx is equal to k, where k is the constant, such that fx, or we can write in function format f, such that from R to R, this is the also symbol, f such that from R to R, because you are putting the values of domain, that will be real for all small x belongs to, for all small x belongs to real, you can write small x belongs to real. This function is known as constant function. Then the function fx is known as constant function. See its graph. X-axis, y-axis, this is 0, 0. Now suppose fx is equal to k we have taken, and when you will put x is equal to 1, you will get same result k. X is equal to 2, you will get same result k. X is equal to 3, you will get same result k. Suppose this is the point k. 0, comma k is the point, and you will get this type of line that will be parallel to x axis. Y is equal to k you can take. So this is y is equal to k, or fx is equal to k. This is constant function. This is constant function. Now, what is its domain? So, domain, first of all, write the functions. Function format fx is equal to k. And domain, it's a domain. Domain will be real number R, and range will be also real number, that is R. Now see, this is the constant function, and its terminology, fx is equal to k means y is equal to k. Y is equal to k is the equation of line parallel to x axis and passing through the point 0, comma k. This is its a terminology, and these points you have to learn. Now suppose its range will be not real number, this will be k, because you will get the same result. y is equal to k. This one we can write here. Also in curly bracket. Because there is single element, so k. Range is k. Now come to the next type of function. And next type of function is modulus function. See. Now I will come to the third type. Third type is modulus function. Third type is modulus function. So let y is equal to fx be a function. Y is equal to fx be a function. Such that from real to real means mapping is going from real to real, and this function are said to be function is said to be modulus function. Function if fx is equal to mod x and mod x result is there are two possible values, that is x minus x and x. And minus x is for x is less than 0 and x is for x is greater than 0, equal to 0. When you will draw on graph, so what you will get the result? You will get this type of function. Suppose this is x-axis, this is y-axis, this is origin. So you will get this type of graph. This function is known as modulus function. So here is y is equal to minus x, here is y is equal to x, for x is less than 0, for x is greater than equal to 0. This is the modulus function. And its domain function is as shown. So domain will be, first of all write the function. Function is fx is equal to mod of x. And mod of x result is this. And domain. Domain result. What will be the domain? Domain is real number. What is domain? The values of x at which the function is defined. Jis value pe function defined hota hai, wahi hamara domain hota hai. So, all real number, the function is defined. And what is the range? Range you can write. When you will put x is equal to minus 3, so you will get the positive result. Y is always positive. So what we can say about y? Y means range that will be from 0 to infinity in open intervals. 0 to infinity. This is the modulus functions. Now I will come to the next function, that is signum function. Signum function. Next is signum function. Heading is signum function. So let y is equal to fx be a function. Let y is equal to fx be a function. The function y is equal to fx is said to be, it is said to be signum function, or also y is equal to fx be a function such that from real to real, f is a mapping that is going from real to real, we can say. Are said to be signum function. When? What is the condition for any function are said to be signum function? If fx is equal to mod of x whole upon x, and second condition is 0. For mod of x whole upon x, this is valid only for x is not equal to 0, and this is only for x is equal to 0. And you know, its result will be minus 1 or 1. So mod x result, you know, mod x result is minus 1, 1, 0, and you can take minus 1. How? So this function also we can write is of the form, here I am writing, zero value for x is equal to 0. And x is not equal to 0, condition when x is greater than 0, suppose when you will take greater than 0 value, you will get 1. And suppose you are taking less than 0, so you will get minus 1. So there will be 3 possible values. For x is equal to 0, x is greater than 0, and x is less than 0. Is known as signum function. Is known as signum function. Is known as signum function. So what will be its domain? Suppose I am going to draw the graph. I am going to draw the graph here. Suppose this is x-axis, this is y-axis, and now this is negative y, this is negative x. And you know, for x is greater than 0, you will get the values 1. So for x is greater than 0, there is possible positive values of x that is going from left to right. This is x is greater than 0. And this is for x is less than 0, and this is at x is equal to 0. So for x is greater than 0, you will get 1. Means for x is greater than 0, you will get 1. And for x is, this is 0 comma 1 coordinates, and for x is less than 0, you will get minus 1. This is 0 comma minus 1. Now for x is equal to 0, value is 0. This is 0. Now this is known as signum function. And what will be its domain? Suppose we have to find out their domain. Domain is the set of real number, that is R. And what you are get the values of y means range. What is the range? For every real values of x that is greater than 0, you will get the values of y, that is 1. You are getting the values similarly 1, 0, minus 1. So range will be equal to minus 1, comma 0, comma 1. This is the range. Now this graph is real number R that is completed. See, now I will come to the next type. The next type is square root function. Now fifth type is square root function. Let y is equal to fx be a function. The function such that f is a mapping, or function f such that from real to real is said to be square root function if fx is equal to root x. Fx is equal to root x. So we can write real to real, this is the format. You can write here function. Because mapping is going from real to real, you are putting the values of real to real, and you cannot get the values of negative. So this function is said to be square root function if fx is equal to root of x. So suppose you have to draw the graph, which type of graphs you will get? X-axis, this is y-axis. Now when you will draw the graph of square root function, you will get this type of curve. So this curve is passes through origin, and y is equal to root x function, and its a domain will be, what will be its domain? Domain will be from 0 to infinity. Domain lies from 0 to infinity. 0 to infinity also belongs to real. So from 0 to infinity, towards the infinity it is open. And what will be the range? Range will be also from 0 to infinity in open. Now this is the function, its domain and its range. Now this type is completed. Now come to the next type. The next type is reciprocal function. Next type is reciprocal function. A function function y is equal to fx is said to be reciprocal function if fx is equal to 1 by x such that x cannot be equal to 0. Fx is equal to x such that fx is equal to 1 by x that is not equal to 0. So when you will draw a graph, so which type of shape you will get? Suppose this is x and y axis. And when you will draw the graph, when you will put x is equal to 0, you will get y infinity. So this type of curve you will obtain or you will get. Similarly, when you will see or put negative result of x, you will get this type of curve. So this is the type of reciprocal function. And what is its domain? Means function such that fx is equal to 1 by x for x is not equal to 0. And domain and range. What will be its domain? Domain will be all real number except 0. Now what will be the range? Range will be also all real number except 0. So this is the domain and range of function. Now this type is completed. Now come to the next type. The next type is greatest and smallest integer function. See. Now heading is greatest integer function. So let y is equal to fx be a function such that from real to real is said to be greatest integer. Greatest integer if fx will be equal to greatest integer. This is the mathematical symbol to write the greatest integer in square brackets. So what is its value? See with the help of example. Suppose your values of x lies from, greater than 0, less than 1, greater than 0 or equal to 0, suppose less than 1. So greatest integer of x, you can take 0. You have to take smallest result. Similarly, when you will take, suppose 2 is, x is greater than equal to 2 and less than 3, so its greatest integer will be 2. Suppose 3 is less than equal to x is less than 4. So greatest integer you will get 3. So when you will draw the graph, what you will get the result? See, this is x-axis, this is y-axis. Now for x is 0 or 1, for x is 0 or 1, suppose this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4. So which type of graph or curve you will get? For x is less than 2, suppose x is less than 2, you will get 1. Suppose x is less than 3, x is less than 3, you will get 2. So this type of curve you will get. Now this topic is totally completed, and for lowest integer function you can take its greater value. Now this is completed.